the cheapest projector of all. Today you will know why it is. Intro and we begin. Digital greetings to everyone. A good option to have a home theater, and that are becoming very popular, are the projectors. In this channel I have not yet reviewed any. Today I am going to start with the most humble of all, the cheap mini projector, the YG300. But this projector is only the beginning of a series of projectors that I am going to analyze, starting with this low end. Because then it will come a mid range, a high range, and a premium range. And since I know that you are very demanding, there are qualities for all pockets. So if you are not subscribed to my channel, subscribe immediately, and activate the notification bell, so you don't miss this super saga of projectors. That is going to be very good. There are many aspects to consider when choosing a projector, such as the type of lamp, power of the light, the reflection, etc. But perhaps the most important of all are the lumens. Just as we use the meter to measure distances, a lumen is the unit of measurement used in lighting, to measure the amount of light emitted by a bulb or a lamp. Simple, isn't it? The more lumens a lamp has, the better its power and brightness. But against it, the worse its consumption, its temperature, and therefore its useful life. The YG300 is the cheapest of all projectors, and for obvious reasons it is not the best, but it has its technology, and we are going to see how it performs. And how sure are you going to ask, Javier, which is better, smart TV or projector? Well, stay until the end to see the conclusion. And to help you answer that question, let's go with the unboxing. This is the box in which this small projector arrives, where the most prominent thing is the word LED, and later on you will know why. Here inside we find the mini projector, well protected, and a small user manual. In a first contact with the equipment, is you can see some of its main features, and you can also see that it is made entirely of plastic. As accessories, it includes an audio and video cable with RCA connectors, a very basic infrared remote control, and a 12-volt and 2-amp power adapter to deliver you power to this device. Although for its price I am not going to discuss its quality, which is very basic, if it bothers me that the lens does not include a plastic cover to avoid scratches and fingerprints that we accidentally leave when handling it. On one side it has a small lever for the focus control. The front has a slot that is the audio output of the small built-in speaker. The top is the button panel of this projector, and also a small LED status light. On the other side is the HDMI input, a USB 2.0 input, the input of the voltage adapter, and a power micro switch. At the rear is the infrared sensor for remote control, a micro SD slot, an audio input and analog video, a micro USB port for external power, and an audio output to get the sound to some amplifier equipment. And in part the bottom has a standard 1/4-inch thread to mount it on any common tripod. Despite being a low-end model, this mini projector has enough physical connections for most of our video sources. This mini projector costs $40 on average. And I make it clear that for that price, its specifications are very limited, but even so it has been liked by a sector of the public, and has been very sold. Its main features are LCD projection technology, LED light source with 30,000 hours of life, lamp brightness from 400 to 600 lumens, projected image size from 24 to 60 inches, distance to the screen from 0.8 to 2 meters, native resolution 320 by 240 pixels. According to its manual, it supports full HD at 1080p, two formats of 4:3 and 16:9 screen ratio. Forced ventilation system with mini fan. Does not integrate any type of wireless connection. Does not integrate the Android operating system. Does not include a keystone correction system. Why, if the processor is the brain of a device, the light source is the heart of a projector. Some years ago this light source was a glass lamp with pressurized mercury vapor, and it was a bit complex to build. And for that reason it was expensive, but also in operation, it worked very hot, which greatly reduced its useful life. But then the engineers introduced LED light, and developed LEDs that were increasingly powerful and efficient. I know, because working with LEDs is my passion. and my years I have been collecting, different shapes, patterns and colors. Well, a few nomas. And I did not want to stay with the desire to know, what kind of LED, is the one who brings this projector. It is the first time that I will open a projector, and I already want to see how it is built inside, and how it uses light to project the images. It is not enough to just remove the screws, since it is not so easy to disassemble it, but in the end I managed to remove the top cover. I will remove three screws, and then I will disconnect the speaker. This delicate flag. And the fan cables. And now if I will have access to the main card. Here is the infrared sensor for the remote control. The micro SD reader. The connection ports. And the processor, which is an LCD image controller chip. And which sends its signals to the imaging unit, that is just below this black plastic. Before I must remove this little card, what are the analog connections? And now I will carefully remove the source of light, and then I will remove this plastic cover. This is the unit where the image projection is generated. And this fan is important to prevent our light source from burning. Which is this LED SPCL, and generates so much power and heat for its size, which is coupled to a block sink aluminum. If you look at the code of this LED as YG300, and how it will be important in the team, which he receives its model number this mini projector. A small temperature switch protects the LED, so that it does not exceed 75 degrees Celsius. If not, it will turn it off in an emergency, preventing it from burning. Very good protection. The operation is very interesting. Basically, the power of light generated by this LED is concentrated in this camera. It passes through here. It deviates in this mirror, and is projected out through the lens. But before reaching the mirror, the light passes through this polarizing filter, and also this magnifying glass, that amplifies the images. But what images are you talking about? If up to here there is only a simple LED that generates light, well, in this slot goes the small LCD screen, or image unit controlled by the processor. This screen defines the resolution of the projector, and although this is very low, the fault is not only hers, if not also the processor, which is a very cheap chip. But it is what you do, when you want to obtain a product of $40 or less. Now yes, before closing this device, with a flannel I will do a good cleaning to the lens, to erase all traces that I left with my fingers. Even though it is a very cheap equipment and of average quality, everything that can be learned from it is incredible, right? And I hope this has been a good experience for you. As well as it was for me. It is always a risk to take apart a new team. But it is also a lot of fun. Also, I also know how to do it, and if I did it right it should work in a... Let's try it. As a cinema I will use the garage of my house, where I have a wide wall, to use it in the projection of the tests. The bad thing is that this is also Rick's playground, and where the captain rules, the sailor does not send it. I will use this fragile aluminum tripod, since the equipment only weighs half a kilo and will resist it very well. Addition, this tripod brings its 1/4-inch bolt, to firmly attach the projector. And with this have control over the position angles. From now on I tell you, that they must forgive any deficiency in this projector. Do not get demanding, or anything, because for the $40 it costs, there is not much to demand from this low end. It is 5 PM and I am going to turn it on purpose. To show you that it is appropriate to use it with ambient light. Since the brightness is very poor and the image is hardly visible, that is caused by all the light that enters through the large doors of my garage, so I better turn off the equipment and wait for the night that there is less light. Now we are already at night, and I am going to turn on this mini projector. The first thing I notice is the noise of the internal fan. It is not much for me, but perhaps for some more sensitive people, it becomes annoying. Captured with a microphone, it sounds like this. I'm lighting a small light of my room to measure the distance, and I located the projector to 1.5 meters from the wall, that I get a projection of 43 inches as the medium TV. Now turn out the light to see the configuration options of this equipment. First I will make the best possible approach that this mini projector allows me. In the upper part are the only four options available. Movies, music, photos and texts. On the left side we can select from where we want to read the video source, either via USB, via HDMI, or via the RCA analog input. and by pressing the setting button, we can change some very basic options for images, sound, date and time, and a few advanced ones. At 30 centimeters from the wall, we can see in greater detail the pixels of this low resolution that I had already told you that it is not very good, but I would not call it garbage either. Only receive the quality for which you are paying. And this other shot is at 1 meter from the wall. It is obvious that the further away you are, less details will be seen. Maybe I will lose quality because of my wall that is melon color. So I will use this white fabric to compare. And you will say if it improves the quality or the brightness. As you can see, now the right half is with the white cloth. How do you see it? And now I will put it in the left half. Well, for me, it does not gain brightness on. The contrary, it takes away. So I will leave it on the wall. I will just connect a USB memory to see how it reproduces some photos that I have here. And this is all the best that can be seen. How advantages, it shows them presentation type, and also adjusts the photo format, going from 3 to 4 to 16 to 9 automatically. But since this projector does not have wireless connections, it is very necessary to connect an external device. How will I do it to enjoy content online? Some devices like my Fire Stick do not fit because the power connector takes up space. Luckily, it comes with this adapter, and so I can connect it. Just have to choose HDMI and that's it. In this way you can project your contents on this mini projector. Since it is the only way to connect to the internet, of course, it is mandatory to use this device in a semi-dark or totally dark place. Since as soon as we turn on a small light, it can easily be it loses its brightness. And after having known its LED, I do not believe in those 600 lumens that this device promises. So that you can hear the sound of this projector, I will put a microphone on my ear, and I will sit 1 meter away from the projector, to be at an average distance. As the integrated speaker is small, the sound is not spectacular, but at least something defends itself. I will. Expand the screen a little more, and for that I will put the projector 2 meters from the wall. Now we will have a 60-inch screen. That is the maximum recommended by the manual. Likewise, you will continue to see your content, but when you make the screen larger, the pixels will also enlarge, as I show you in these close-up shots. Although if you are very light, hey, maybe that is not a big problem. But I will ignore the manual and take it even further. I will install it 2.8 meters from the wall to achieve an 80-inch screen projection. And I think it is the most you can see without the resolution and becomes a problem. If you do not tell me what you think of their images projected on this boundary location, I think they are not of the bad everything. Always remembering that only costs about $40. And price could be an alternative for those who have more money to invest. I told you, it's a low-end projector, but it didn't behave that badly, or do you think so? I think that for $40 it is just enough. Of course, I do not recommend this projector if you are looking to replace your smart TV in the living room, since it has very low resolution and little brightness. For that there are better options. But I am sure that for other more basic uses, for that price it will be great. I would recommend it perhaps as your first television, for the children's room, or for their virtual classes. Since as it is not direct light, but reflected on the wall, their eyes will tire less and they will rest better. Or if you have a nightclub, you could use it as a cheap means to pass publicity. If you got this far, it is because you liked this video. So I invite you to see more of my content. I try hard to explain it well, and make it very enjoyable so that you get bored. In addition to reviewing the technology, in this channel we always learn something. That is why I humbly ask you to like my brother. And if you also subscribe to my channel, it would be great, because that way you motivate me to follow. are creating this type of educational content. Help me and democratize technology. Until the next video.